"How did you manage to do that?" asked the Tin Woodman in amazement. "Polychrome is a powerful fairy."
"She was," said the giantess, "but now she's a canary bird. One day, after a rain, Polychrome danced off the rainbow and fell asleep on a little mound in this valley not far from my castle. The sun came out and drove the rainbow away, and before Polly wakened, I stole out and transformed her into a canary bird in a gold cage studded with diamonds. The cage was so she couldn't fly away. I expected she'd sing and talk and we'd have good times together, but she has proved no company for me at all. Ever since the moment of her transformation, she has refused to speak a single word."
"Where is she now?" inquired Woot, who had heard the tales of lovely Polychrome and was much interested in her.
"The cage is hanging up in my bedroom," said the giantess, eating another biscuit.
The travelers were now more uneasy and suspicious of the giantess than before. If Polychrome, the rainbow's daughter, who was a real fairy, had been transformed and enslaved by this huge woman who claimed to be a Yookoohoo, what was liable to happen to them? Said the Scarecrow, twisting his stuffed head around in Mrs. Yoop's direction. "Do you know, ma'am, who we are?"
"Of course," said she. "A straw man, a tin man, and a boy."
"We are very important people," declared the Tin Woodman.
"All the better," she replied. "I shall enjoy your society the more on that account, for I mean to keep you here as long as I live, to amuse me when I get lonely. And," she added slowly, "in this valley no one ever dies."
They didn't like this speech at all,